Welcome students, my name is Irfan Ahmed and today we are going to study about the cell division and cell cycle. So cell division and cell cycle, we will study both about the division of the cell and about the cycle of the cell. In the division we will study about the various phases of the cell division, and in cell cycle we will study about the different aspects through which the cell goes. Okay. So the topics here which will be discussed are cell division and growth. Second is duplication of the genetic material. Third is mitosis and cytokinesis, and next is meiosis, and next is cell division cycle. So these topics will be discussed here. So we will start from the first topic, that is cell division and growth. So what is cell division and what is growth? Growth, you know that there is an increase in the size, there is increase in some activities, there is an alteration of some activities. Okay, so in unicellular organisms, means those organisms which are made up of a single cell, like there is amoeba, etc. Okay, so cell division, that is the means of reproduction. Okay, they divide because they have to reproduce, and there is the only way to reproduce is by that very way. Okay, and in multicellular organisms, it is the means of tissue growth, means the organisms will grow by this means. Okay, so unicellular organisms cell division is a means of reproduction, while as in multicellular organisms it is the means of tissue growth and maintenance, means the growth of the tissues will occur because of the cell division, and in unicellular organisms the cell division results in the reproduction. Okay, so eukaryotes, their survival depends upon interactions between many cell types, and it's very essential that there must be a balanced distribution, and that balanced distribution must be maintained. And how that is maintained? That's maintained by regulating the process of cell proliferation. Okay, and the growth and the division of different cell populations, that's regulated in different ways, and basic mechanisms are followed which are similar throughout the multicellular organisms. All the basic mechanisms, those all basic mechanisms are similar in the all multicellular organisms. Okay, so most tissues of the body, these grow by increasing their cell number. We know that most of the tissues in our body, these grow by increasing the number of cells, and this growth is highly regulated to maintain a balance between different tissues. Okay, for example, if you take an example of adults, most cell division is involved in tissue renewal rather than growth. So many types of the cells, those undergo continuous replacement, and by that very type of replacement cell division occurs. For example, skin cells are there which are constantly peeled off, and these are replaced by the new cells. Okay, mature differentiated cells, those do not divide, but those don't show any division, but they are removed and the new cells grow because their population is renewed by the division of immature stem cells. There are immature stem cells, these help in their renewal. So in certain other cells, for example, we will take an example of the liver. So mature cells, those remain capable of division to allow growth or to allow regeneration after any injury or after any such episode or evidence. So how, next is how there occurs the depletion of the genetic material. So what is genetic material? In for example, if we take an example of virus, the genetic material is RNA. But in case of multicellular organisms, genetic material is mostly genetic material is DNA, deoxyribonucleic acid. Now how that genetic material duplicates? So before a cell can divide, it has to duplicate the genetic material, and that too accurately, that too completely, because all the information that's encoded in this DNA. So in order to increase the progeny, in order to increase its generations, it has, and in order to survive, it has to duplicate, a cell has to duplicate its genetic material. So how it duplicates its genetic material? It duplicates, a cell duplicates its genetic material by the process of replication. Okay, so this is a complex problem because there is a length of the DNA is too great. Each human chromosome, that consists of a long double spiral, or we can say that helical, or we can say that more than 100 million nucleotides are there. So nucleotide is nitrogen base, phosphate, sugar. Nitrogen base plus phosphate plus sugar, that makes a nucleotide. So there are 100 million nucleotides in a DNA. So it is a great problem for a DNA to replicate. But the duplication of the DNA, deoxyribonucleic acid, that is called DNA replication. And various types of enzymes initiate this process, like, for example, there is DNA polymerase, which initiates the process of DNA replication. Okay, and these progress along the molecules, for example, DNA polymerases, these move from up to down of a molecule, reads all the nucleotides you can see that are linked together to make DNA changes. Okay, so this replication or this duplication of the genetic material that occurs by a process that is called a DNA replication. Replication means formation of DNA from DNA, that is called as DNA replication. Okay. Now, every strand of the DNA, double helix, because the DNA is a double helical structure, okay, and there is a coiled structure, that is a double helical structure, that acts as a template, okay, for the new growing chain. So after replication, each of the two daughter DNA double helix, those contain of one parental strand and one is newly synthesized DNA strand. Means the strand which will be formed from the DNA will have one coil that will be from the parent and one coil that will be from the mother, means one coil from the mother, one coil from the father. Okay, and these in order to replicate, the two strands, DNA strands, that must be unwounded from each other, or that can be unzipped from each other. So in unzipping DNA enzymes, for example, helicases, those unwind the DNA strands, and then other proteins are bonded to its separated strands, so that those proteins can stabilize them and prevent them from pairing again, so that no second pairing can occur. So in addition, for example, there are DNA topoisomerases, which removes the helical twists, means which cuts either one or both strands and then releases the cut. Okay, so these enzymes can also untangle or unknot DNA when it is tightly coiled in a chromatin fiber. Means if the tightening is more than an enzyme, which enzyme can help? Then topoisomerase can help. Okay, so it can unwind the same. So now we have to study about the mitosis and cytokinesis. Cytokinesis means division of the cytoplasm. Okay, so in mitosis, what happens? It is a type of cell division in which one cell gives rise to two genetically identical daughter cells during the process of mitosis. Means there is one cell, it will give rise to two genetically identical daughter cells. Okay, so that is the process of the mitosis. You can see here from the diagram, I have depicted the process of whole process of mitosis. So this is priority mitosis, before mitosis. So each chromosome makes an exact duplicate of itself, and the chromosome then thickens and coils. You can see that. So then that there is a prophase, early prophase, this is early prophase, this is late prophase. Okay, so next, in this double chromosomes, means the doublet chromosomes, their centromeres attach to the spindle fibers, these line up at the mid cell in metaphase, this is metaphase. And this one is anaphase, then this is late anaphase, then next step is here, and at the completion of the mitosis, then there are two cells with the same structures and the number of chromosomes as a parent cell, that will be same. So these are the eight steps which are included in the process of mitosis. So this was one cell, at the end it gave rise to two cells. So two cells arise. So in eukaryotes, we can say that the process of DNA replication and cell division, these occur at different times of the cell division. Okay, and during cell division, DNA condenses, it forms short, tightly coiled, rod-like chromosome. Then each chromosome splits longitudinally, it forms two identical chromatids, then each pair, then that's again divided between two daughter cells during mitosis, a division of the nucleus, which is a process in which chromosomes are propelled by attachment, and that happens to the bundle of microtubules, which are called as mitotic spindles. So this process occurs here. Now mitosis, we can divide it into five phases: prophase, metaphase, anaphase, telophase. So in prophase, what happens? The mitotic spindle forms and the chromosome condenses, as you have seen from the diagram. Then in prometaphase, what happens? Nuclear envelope breaks down, okay, and chromosomes attach to mitotic spindle. Next is both chromatids of each chromosome. These attach to the spindle at a specialized chromosomal region, which is called as kinetochore. In metaphase, then those condensed chromosomes, these align in a plane across the equator of mitotic spindle. And in anaphase, that follows by the separated chromatids, which move abruptly towards opposite spindle poles. And finally, in the last stage, that telophase, a new nuclear envelope, it forms around each set of chromatids. So this is the process of the mitosis. This is the procedure which is followed by a cell during the process of mitosis in order to form a double cell from a single cell in order to carry out the mitotic division. So this was all for the today's lecture. In next topic, we will continue about the mitosis and we will continue about the cell division, that is meiosis. Okay, so this was all for today. Thank you.